All right, guys, welcome back to the next episode on this Radical Red series that we're doing. Today, we have just got our Pokeballs, and we did get our starter in the last episode. So let's go over the Pokemon we got. We did get a Meloetta, which does have an Aurum Berry. It's actually a very good Pokemon to have. Prevents recoil damage, but also we do have Relic Song to swap into her fighting stance if that's what we need to do. But we are going to just go and get some encounters today. I reckon that's all we're going to do. There's at least four we can do. So we've got this grass here. We've got the city above to the left and then at the top as well. So we may as well get that done right now. So let's see what we get for our first encounter of this series. Oh. Okay. You know what? I'll actually take it because we do need a ground type. Sing hit straight away. It's always nice to see. The amount of fails I've had with like Sing and Hypnosis. This is going to be stab, isn't it? Okay, so we can do one more of them. It should leave them in the red unless we get a crit. Ooh. Okay, we're not taking too much damage. I'm guessing it gets harder on later on in the series. But for now, hopefully we're going to catch our first Pokemon right here. Let's throw a ball and see what happens. I'll definitely take a Hippopotasso, a ground type. Definitely. Get in. We still don't have a layout for this done properly, so I don't really want to show half a layout, if that makes sense. So I will be adding it later on. It will probably be either the next episode now or the one after, but there will be a proper layout with Pokemon, icons, that kind of thing. So let's heal up. What we need to do as well is check Hippopotas's nature's abilities, that kind of thing. So we got healer. May heal ally status problems. Not the greatest, if I'm really honest. And all it knows is tackle. I do think we put a... Is it adamant? Hold on. Adamant's the attack and special attack down, yeah. I think that's the best one for Hippopotas anyway. But we do have this one here. I know we've got 9 Pokeballs, but knowing my luck, I will get a legendary at some point. We're not going to go too much. We're going to go buy 10 of them. I like how potions are less amount in this. We'll buy 10 potions as well. 3 antidotes and then 3 paralyzed heals as well. Not leaving us with any money, but we should be able to get all these encounters at a good point. So, see what we get here. We are in nighttime at the minute as well, so these will have changed. Ooh. Okay. It's a good encounter. Yeah, but as long, if it has a fighting type move, we could lose everything here. Especially with double defense down. Not good. Okay, we can take one of them. That's not a problem. Let's hope. We don't do too much damage here. Heracross is usually a bulky Pokemon though, so. Tangling hair. Wow, okay. Not the greatest of abilities. If I'm honest. It is a Mega though. I'm just going to throw a ball. If we use Sing, it's probably going to fail. Oh. Okay. We are going to go second. Oh, Horn Attack. Not good. We can survive another unless it's a crit. It did endure, so that's fine. We're not going to use a thingy move yet anyhow. Oh, we need to catch this now. Come on, stay in the ball. This might be a runaway. One, two, three. Get in. I will definitely take that. Heracross is a very good Pokemon and has a Mega. I haven't played this game before, but I have heard the Megas are in here. So if so, that is great. That's a really good Pokemon to have. Obviously, the ability is not great. Tangling Hair, it does reduce the speed of Pokemon. But with that said, we should actually change the nature of Heracross to Adamant. For definite. Let's have a look at its stats. Obviously, they do have 6 IVs on each, so special attack down, not bothered by that. Horn attack is a great move to have. So we've got a bug type, fighting type, we have a ground type, and a psychic slash fighting type. So we're not too bad. We're not getting the worst encounters. Do we get a fishing rod here? We do. Okay. We can't take this as an encounter. But what I am going to do is see what we would have got if we did. So let's have a look. What can we find in the water? You've got to be kidding me. Well, that would have been a better encounter. I don't know if there's any rules on running. I don't think there is. That was just to check what Pokemon's there anyway. Route 22, so this is a new encounter as well. We do have the trainer bits here as well with the rival, so and more Pico. Not really what I had in mind. Soundproof. Okay, so we can't put this Pokemon to sleep. That's not great. Quick attack. Oh, wow. Okay, let's go to Hippopotas here. Hopefully do a bit more damage before trying to catch this. I'm not too thrilled about this one. It does have its secondary ability. I do know that. So we might see if we can catch it. I'm not going to spend too many Pokeballs on this. So if we catch it, great. If we don't, we don't. We caught it. Nice. It has Soundproof. So not a bad ability, but not the greatest either. I might start nicknaming Pokemon in the second or third run. But for now, we're not doing too bad. I don't know more Pico's stats. I will get Prodex up by the end of the episode and change its nature. But for now, we do have a few more encounters to get. So we need to go past the old man. So he probably gets stopped here. There you go. Techie TV, yeah, we're not bothered by that. Ooh, we need to get that item, though. It's a shame you don't get your bike till really, really late on red and blue. Right. We do need to use a fishing rod somewhere, though, because your bike was a great mon, and I can't believe we missed out on it, to be honest. Ooh, hold on. Outside packages from the professor. A Dex now. Okay. Also upgrade Pokedex and the National Dex while I'm here. I may also give you these. Some more Oran berries. That's not bad. Oh, you're playing hardcore. Yo, brave you. Ooh. See, I wasn't playing hardcore Nuzlocke. We're just doing a Nuzlocke so we can heal in battle. However, I might change it because have we healed in battle? No. So we're not too far gone. You know what, sod it. We're going to go and fight our battle here. Our rival and see what he has. Hopefully the battles, like the starter Pokemon, go further through on. It does, so we've got a Snuzzle still. Okay. Intimidate. Yeah, that's fine, because I'm not really going to use that. Obviously, we were very lucky to get a good Pokemon from the get-go. Meloetta is so good. And we can go into its fighting form as well. Damn, where did he get Squirtle? I feel like Squirtle might have Bite, so doing a Relic Song here isn't that bad, but we should also be able to change into fighting form, so a Bite won't... Ooh, Rock Tomb. Dropping our speed, though. We will do a Relic Song again. We are still normal, so we should do the same amount of damage, and then we can Quick Attack the next turn. I was going to say, if this gets a Bite now... Forgot that it changes it every time. Oh, we got critted. Okay. So we are going to use an Aurum Berry. Quick Attack. Oh, come on. It's got Aqua Jet at level 8. Level 8? That's insane. I'm glad we had that Aurum Berry, otherwise we potentially could have died there. This is definitely going to have Bite. Oh, a stab. Okay. Didn't actually do that much damage. As much as I thought, anyway. Okay, we need to Quick Attack here. And then we've won. Not as bad as I thought. However, that Squirtle having Aqua Jet could have ruined the entire run right there. It could easily have wiped us out. Because I didn't know it had it. Very close. Let's heal up because we do have a few more encounters to get. So we've got one on Route 2, which is higher up. And then we have Viridian Forest as well. So, we should have, obviously, a full party by then. So, that's really good. Let's hope we get something good here. Ooh, yeah. We already have a Heracross. So, I don't know if this is the same route as below. It's definitely not, is it? You know what? Let's do a quick check. We do have a town map. Route 2, Viridian City, Route 1. No, it just happens... I think the way this randomizer works is it doesn't go off the... route. So, like... Sorry, it goes off the Pokemon that are in every single route. So, if you're using a... You swap in a Pidgey, it will swap every single place that a Pidgey is. Which I don't really like that kind of... randomizer. So if we can, we might use an actual randomizer on it and then just let the playthrough normally, but that'll be for the next run, if anything. So right, let's tackle this. We need to get this down because Sing wasn't working, and we are doing enough damage to get it into the red, I believe. Nope, we're not. Let's just try and catch it anyway. It's nice to see the newer Pokemon in this kind of environment. I've not actually done a ROM hack where Gen 8s and stuff are in here. So it is actually a really cool thing to see. I am tempted to use our ability capsules though. We got Premier Ball. If I use this, does it use it straight away? Oh. Okay, we've only got one ability on every Pokemon. Interesting. It's okay for now, but interesting. I wonder if the randomizer's not done the second ability. Basically, when you do another randomizer, you can click the setting, which is like, always give a Pokemon two abilities. Doesn't seem to have worked with their in-game randomizer. So, like I said, we might eventually end up changing this just to make it harder. But I will look into that. because we don't want it to be too easy, and also we don't want to be getting the same encounters constantly. But I am thinking we're getting a bit too far ahead with Meloetta and with none of our other Pokemon. I am most likely going to grind levels in between episodes, so you will see a level increase. I don't really know if I want it. If it survives a horn attack, we'll get it. Oh, wow. It really... Ooh. Type coverage. I'll take that. A lot of type coverage. That's Thunder Fang and Ice Fang. Oh, that's us dead. Okay. Who's got the lowest attack here? 13, 14, 17. Zigzagoon it is, but Zigzagoon might die. That is some amount of type coverage. It's actually insane. What are we not going to take damage from? So we are in the fighting type mode and normal. So we should be okay and we shouldn't take too much damage. I'm not going to even try and do a sing. I am just going to throw a ball. This is just basically to minimize the amount of damage we are taking. We got it. I know I wasn't too happy with the Snubbull. However... the type coverage of the moveset it has gives us a big advantage. So obviously it is a fairy normal. Oh no, just fairy in this game. Okay. Suction cups, not that too bothered with, but these here gives us so much type coverage. Will help us out a lot in the next episode. I am just going to go and heal. And then I'm going to leave this episode here and we'll move on to Brock in the next one once we get through Viridian Forest. I will probably do a longer episode tomorrow or the next day just to get to Brock and potentially defeat him because it will be our first gym battle. So it will be an interesting episode to be with. But anyway, I'm going to leave this right here. Thank you all for watching this new series. If you are enjoying it, please leave a comment below with what you're enjoying about it. It is my first Nuzlocke in a while, so I'm hoping it we do pretty well. I don't think we're going to win, though. I've seen a lot of people lose. Especially, go and watch Original 151. He does stream this live. So definitely going to pay it a watch. Thank you all for watching. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll speak to you all in the next one.